It's now been a year since Wuhan, China, saw the first of many coronavirus lockdowns around the world. Since then, nearly 100 million people have been infected with COVID-19. Our David Culver reports now from the original epicenter of the coronavirus outbreak.
It is a city whose name evokes mystery, allegations of cover-up, and agony. Wuhan, China. CNN returning to this, the original epicenter of the coronavirus outbreak. On January 23rd, 2020, this metropolis of more than 11 million residents locked down. We left hours before, beginning a two-week quarantine in Beijing. For 76 days, Wuhan remained sealed off.
And here we are again, back 1 year later, the Huanan Seafood Market. This at one point was believed to have been, by Chinese authorities, the ground zero of this outbreak.
This time last year, security had ushered us away within minutes of reporting.
Now, January 2021, no security here. We've been walking around for several minutes. They don't seem to care.
That was until we started looking inside. We noticed some people working behind the gate. Suddenly, a seemingly random passerby on a bike shouted at us, saying, "Don't be sneaky." He later identified himself vaguely as working for the government. He told us to walk around and try the entrance.
Can we go in?
We can go in that way.
Said apparently we can go in, so we'll see if we can actually get inside the market.
But I'm going to ask this guy, can you go in? You can't go inside? Oh, tell him we have a COVID test, a negative COVID test.
Okay, you just can't get it.
You can't get it.
Don't take the pictures.
Okay, no pictures.
Yeah.
So clearly, a bit sensitive. Perhaps it's because we're foreigners or because we're journalists.
The virus's origin has become highly politicized. U.S. officials accusing China of covering up and allowing the virus to spread. China defensive, saying the Trump administration was deflecting blame for its own mishandling. A team from the WHO is now in Wuhan, tasked with trying to find out the truth. And yet, geopolitics aside, the human suffering, it is universal. Young Min spoke with us knowing she could face pressures from officials, but a mother who's lost her only daughter has no more to lose.
When I sat down, you thanked me for getting the truth out. What is the truth as you know it?
The local officials did not tell us about the pandemic, she said. If measures were taken, I would not have sent my child to the hospital, which was the source of the infection. Last January, Young's 24-year-old daughter had been receiving treatment for cancer. She contracted COVID-19 and died in early February. When I speak about this, some parts of my heart still ache, she said. Amidst the deep pain, we also encountered moments of hope in our return. On the eve of the lockdown last year, we visited this fruit market. This woman selling sugarcane told me at the time that she was terrified. She stayed, fearing the financial burden. 12 months later, we met again. At that time, I was crying all the time, she told me. We were suffering and scared. Above her face mask, the pain still visible in her eyes. She says the people of Wuhan are resilient, likening them to heroes.
I'm so glad to see you in person and to know that you made it through the lockdown and you're healthy.
The market mood, remarkably different from last year. Business, bustling, people much more at ease.
Would you say Wuhan is back open and on the path to recovery?
It's not just starting from now, he says. It started very early, to be honest. In my opinion, Wuhan had already begun to recover since mid to late March. Delivery driver Lao Ji has become well known on Chinese social media as he chronicled life during the lockdown. The then and now are striking. A city desolate amidst the lockdown, followed by a summer with packed pool party images that shocked a socially distanced world outside of China. And a New Year celebration that brought Wuhan residents shoulder to shoulder. Though with new cluster outbreaks in the north of China, many here in Wuhan once again wearing face masks, cautious of the lingering unknowns, and still surrounded by the haunting memories of a lockdown that kept millions of residents, along with their grief, sealed inside. For some, only now, 12 months later, it is just beginning to surface. David Culver, CNN, Wuhan.